Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning. Judgment is a 9-letter word which most people don't get the meaning of. Most people give the judgments about other people and they don't think what they're saying and how it can affect their life for the worst or for the better, mostly for the worst. The worst part of this all is someone will just randomly appear in your life and he will give a silly statement about you and he'll just walk off. Like this, nothing happened. And for you, it's if you take it to your heart, things get worse. You might go into depression and many other things. I say this all by experience because I have been through this. I was judged by my own friends, I would say so-called friends. It all started when I shifted my school into a new area. And the first 2 years went really smooth. There was nothing which went wrong. I was getting good grades, I was getting good friendship, I was getting good chats, my teachers loved me, and everything was brilliant. But I have this thing in my heart that it's a flight which is bound to crash, and that's what happened. I crashed and I crashed hard. My friends suddenly backed off, all of them, suddenly. And I gave them space. It's a 2-year, you know, friendship. So I didn't want it to just go. So I back off a little bit to give them space. But they stopped talking to me. They started talking about this random show which I didn't watch and I didn't want to. So I didn't really mind. But then the thing which I really hated and the thing which happened which forced me to go into depression was a complete cutoff. They used to go to events, they used to go to parties, they used to study together and I wasn't there. And I knew this all. I knew this because of course I'm not an idiot who won't get it, that they're talking about something where I wasn't present. And this, when I went into depression, my studies dropped, my grades dropped, I went down like a stone of sky. And my teachers didn't really get it, why this all was happening, nor I could talk to anyone about it, because most people would call me a loser. That's what the modern generation calls you, if you don't have friends and you can't make one. And that's when my dad walked into my room. Normally he would just ask me about studies and how my day went, and I used to lie about it was great and my studies are going great. Though he knew my grades, that they were falling, and he would say, no problem, it's just the start of a new chapter and you get on with it. But that one day he had another look in his eyes and he went on his face, it felt different, as if he knew what was going on in my life. Might be a talk with the principal, but I don't get it because my dad doesn't come to my school a lot. My mom does, and I don't know about it, anything that would happen. He asked, what's going on in your life? How is school? And I, being, you know, really emotional, I told him everything I had. And this really, you know, he told me only one thing. Whenever I was saying this all, that I will get you out of this, and I promise. And he lived up to his promise. He actually shifted my school again, but this was for the betterment. I shifted country, and I went into my home country where my cousin lived, and I now live in a boarding house, which is great. I have great friends. They really know me better than anyone else. And today I'm way more happier than I was before, and this is all because of my dad. And first thing I learned, that do not let anyone else walk into your life and disturb it and just walk away. Okay? Don't judge, do not judge anyone by the chapter they walk in on.